gather round, everyone, and hear again the tale of Drakfu.
Welcome back, everybody, and happy Monday. I hope everybody has had a good weekend, but now it's time for us to resume the tale of Drakfu. And we are since done in Dragonblight, so I wanted to be able to start from Venomspite as we make our way to the Grizzly Hills. Now, I'm still waiting on the comments to see whether or not you guys want to see the final quest lines wrapped up in Dragonblight. Unfortunately, I thought we were going to get some Arthas coverage in here, but it looks like the Horde end didn't really get any. So, here we go. We are on our way over to the Grizzly Hills, the next zone that would be on our map, anyway. You could technically, at this point... I knew a lot of people at opening opening week for, like, opening couple of months for Wrath of the Lich King, where they were about 74, 75. And then at that point, you had a choice. You actually didn't have to go to the Grizzly Hills. You could technically go to Zoldrak at that point if you wanted to. Some people actually inked out every bit of experience they could get and were probably 75. And I think at that point, Shildazar Basin would have also opened up. But we're going to go ahead and follow this as the flow suggests so that we can cover all of the ground. So you'll see we're leaving kind of the glacier-esque area in favor of kind of the redwoods. That's what Grizzly Hills is. Now, our first quest here is going to be heading over to Conquest Hold to grab our first set of quests. So you can already see this has got more of a sunnier vibe than I would actually dare say even Howling Fjord did. And people might recognize the music that's going on behind me. this is actually what I used a lot of the time in Outland for flying music, and it's actually one of my favorite tracks in the Wrath soundtrack. I never get tired of hearing about this. It's called Totems of the Grizzlemaw. And it symbolizes Grizzly Hills to me. Just all these heavy violins very much a laid-back kind of atmosphere. In fact, like in numerous school projects, I use Totems of the Grizzlemaw, and I'm not repentant about it. I love this track. And you can see we already have a place full of lush wildlife. I will admit this is actually one of my favorite zones of Northrend, and it's just because of how laid-back it kind of feels. And here we are. We are at Conquest Hold. It's quite a bit of quests to actually take on, but first, Light Path, always do that. Is it in here? Yep. So we're going to talk to Conqueror Krenna and report in. Glory to the
Who are you?
I am Drakfu, reporting for duty, I guess.
Tell me why I shouldn't split you in two where you stand. Farewell.
The Conqueror's task. The Horde is a magnificent war machine, and you are nothing but a cog.
Oh, okay. I'm in charge of securing fuel for this machine. If I fail, the machine fails. Lumber, ore, water, it's all here and we want it. And so does the Alliance. Before we can move against the human scum, we need to solidify our control over the Western region. Speak to Sergeant Nazgrim about eradicating the Vrykul in Voldrune, and then maybe, if you turn out not to be a complete failure, we'll send you on further tasks.
For the Horde.
Now, Nazgrim. That name should sound familiar for some people, for veteran WoW players. Nazgrim's an interesting case in the Horde because he's actually a young soldier that we have seen literally make his way through the ranks. And it just so happens that so people might recognize him from Missa Pandaria, where he eventually became a raid boss in the Siege of Orgrimmar. So at that point, but that's the cool part about this, is that we literally saw him become a sergeant and raise himself up through the ranks to become, later on the raid boss, General Nazgrim. So I always like that concept when they fuel characters within game that we can all care about and we all know who they are. So here is the young Sergeant Nazgrim.
Loktar. So, Krenna sent you to me? She must have not liked you very much. But then again, who does she like? Cracking this Vrykul outpost is going to be a tough, tough job.
Okay.
A show of strength.
Preparations for war are underway in the Vrykul village of Voldrune to the southwest. Voldrune's Thane cannot field a large army, but with our forces spread thin, we are still at risk. We cannot risk giving the Thane and his men an opportunity to attack, so we must take the battle to them. If you are truly a monk of the Horde, you will relish the chance to demonstrate our strength. cut down the Huskarls and prove their dragon to this Dragonflayer clan that the Horde is not to be trifled with.
And people might remember in Howling Fjord, we dealt a lot with the Dragonflayer clan. Specifically, the Alliance deal with it a little bit more than we do. But yeah, the Dragonflayer clan is actually also out way into Howling Fjord as well. And it looks like he has a second quest for me. Yes, the Flamebinder secrets.
Even as the Alliance cowards attack our positions, the Dragonflayer Vrykul outpost of Voldrum to the southeast prepares for war. The Vrykul are far from the strongest enemy we face here, but we must eliminate them before they can truly threaten us. Their most powerful warriors are permitted to ride half-trained proto-drakes into battle. To control the beasts, their flame binders create powerful talismans. You'll need to slay them and take the talismans if our plan is to work.
Go forth to victory.
So we have a bunch of quests actually to take on since this is our first outpost in Grizzly Hills. Next up is going to be from Hide Trader Junique.
What you looking for?
Grey hides for the Horde, man. Only the base for our troops. Grey warg hides. Let me tell you something, man. When you get put in charge of outfitting the armies of the Horde, you go through a lot of hides. I would think so. Conqueror Krenna, the she-wolf running this place, she gave me a tight deadline. If I don't outfit her regiment by week's end, she's gonna have me wrestling bears in the pit. But the thing over there. Help me out and I'll pay you top price. I'll be needing hides from Grey Mist Hunters. You'll find them all around the pockets to the north, hunting stag. Remember, mon, top price. In other words, he doesn't want to end up in the pit. So then we also have one from Provisioner Lorkrum. Lorkran. There we go.
And honor.
Some supplies for the road. Perhaps a refreshment to enjoy while you watch the fights.
Supplemental income.
Hail, monk. You'll find here at Conquest Hold, we buy and sell what Krenna wants to buy and sell. At the price that Krenna wants us to buy and sell. All this is stifling business. I'm hoping to make a little bit of coin on the side and feed our grunts at the same time. Why don't you go hunt down some stag and bring me the venison? They're numerous in the area, so bring me only the best meat.
Alright. I think we get some quests over here. We may not have unlocked them just yet. Okay, so we already have a couple of good quests to be able to go take on, which is mainly hunting stuff and going to take care of the Dragonflayer clan, which you can see just ahead. So, without further ado, because I want to be able to get this stuff done, questy break, go! Alright, we got all of the tasks done. It took a while, but we made it work. We've got provisions, and we also killed a bunch of Vrykul. We're not going to irritate anybody here. So let's go ahead and turn all this stuff in before we talk to Krenna. So, Lorkran.
Oh, come on.
Supplemental income.
You get that venison yet, Drakfu?
Yes, I did!
Nice job, Drakfu. These will feed two or three grunts each. Not bad.
Okay. So, no additional quest from him. And then we also have Hide Trader Junik.
Greetings, man.
Grey Warg hides. You get those hides, man?
Yes, I did.
You're a lifesaver, brother. If you're interested in more work, there's more where that came from. Okay. I won't say no to that. Oh, that's really close to being an upgrade. In fact, the stamina is, but I don't want to lose the crit. A minor substitution. Krenna, she be wanting war guides for all the outfits. There's not gonna be enough war guides for her army, though. Not now, not ever. Those wargs, they be skinny, man. Here's what we're gonna do, if you can keep a secret, that is. East of Voldrum, there'll be grizzly bears as fat as an ogre. Those large hides, those we can use. Hurry, brother. Krenna's not known for her patience. Okay, so we need to go get 6 grizzly hides for him. And first of all, we need to talk to Nazgrim and report in.
Krenna must doubt my abilities while our elite warriors march out to...
Is that the voice that I did? I think it is.
While our elite warriors march out to face the Alliance and their trapper allies, or wreak havoc amongst the trolls, I better sign to mop up these pesky Dragonflayer Vrykul. Perhaps if we combine our efforts, we can both prove ourselves in the Conqueror's sight.
So a show of strength.
You have done exactly as I asked. We've got the Dragon Flayers on the defensive, and it'll soon be time to deal with their leader.
Okay. And then the Flamebinder secrets.
Did you collect those talismans?
Yes, I did.
With the power of the talismans, the Drake has no choice but to obey your commands. The Thane's fate is sealed.
The Thane of Voldroom.
With the flame-bued talismans, we can finally challenge the Thane. His favorite mount is a ferocious proto-drake called Flamebringer. It is kept bound in chains in the western part of Voldroom. But with the power of the talismans, you should be able to bend it to your will and use it against the Thane. Once you have Flamebringer under your control, search the tops of the towers of Voldroom for the Thane and use Flamebringer to destroy him.
Straight. Okay, so we need to take care of these two quests. Wow, our quest kind of narrowed, but it's all right. That's kind of the way that this goes. Now, it's funny that Nazgrim brought up the Alliance, because there actually is like a PvP-based objective area that you could win, and there's actually two. One is an entire zone, and then one is this one, where basically if you earn control, you get dailies. So I don't remember what faction they actually work for. I think it's mostly for PvP. In fact, I'll bet money on that. There we go. Take some Tiger Lily. And let's go ahead and take care of Flamebringer. And by the way, once again, happy Monday, everybody. I hope everybody had a good weekend. And for me, it's just been, I've been getting a bunch of stuff done, trying to get caught up. And thankfully, for the most part, I am caught up. So I'm happy about that. Let's go ahead and talk to Flamebringer here. Thane Torvald Erikson's temperamental protodrake is chained up here. Unchain and control Flamebringer. Yes, you can control him. It's fun. So basically, we take this proto-drake, this big proto-drake, and take out the Thane, who just so happens to be at the top of this tower. Now you might see why we actually do this here. Let's see. I think Flame Breath is the one we actually need to use. And then there we go. Okay, so one of the things I actually like to do is you can only ride him for a certain amount of range. And I just try and get rid of him right here, because otherwise he will throw you off. But he is free! Be free, Flamebringer! Alright, so the next task that we have is for the Grizzlies. So let's go ahead and take care of that. And with that, Questy Break, go! Alright, now that we've taken care of the grizzly hides, I know a lot of people might be a little irritated when I go into questing breaks so early, but the bottom line is that when it's collecting quests, I figure we might as well just get the collecting done and then get back into the lore and all that fun stuff. So, again, happy Monday, everybody. And, yeah, we are continuing on in the Tale of Drakfu. Here's hoping we don't have any other mistakes, but I'm making doubly sure that we don't have them. So don't worry too much about that. Okay, so we are back in Conquest Hold. Let's go ahead and turn in these quests. First of all, for the Hide Trader.
You got the good stuff, man.
Minor substitution. You get those hides, mon. Yes, I did. I mean, you're dead, mon. Take this as payment. Oh, and there we go. Here are some upgrades. It's a bearskin helmet. Junix cover-up. We have a small problem. Grizzly hides. They're brown, mon. Tink, tink. I got it, mon. It's like this. Gray is black and white all mixed up. You get me some coal and some flour. I'll grind it all up and dust the hides with it. No one will know that better. Blacksmith smell coal for smelting, and you can get flour from the provisioner. Okay, so we are keeping a very big secret from Conqueror Krenna. And Sergeant Nazgrim, let's report in.
The few remaining Dragon Flayers dare not challenge us after your battle with the Thane. Show no mercy to our enemies. That is the way of the Horde.
And with that we get... Ooh, okay, now we're starting to get some legit upgrades. So I am very happy about that. Onward to Camp Onequa.
While we build Conquest Hold, I sent Scout Vortok to make contact with our Tonka allies in the east. They're based in Campo Nekwa, which is the easternmost part of Grizzly Hills, beyond Grizzlemaw. Make the journey there, hear Voktar's report, and offer your assistance with anything he and the local chieftain may need. Your contributions to Conquest Hold have been exemplary, and I know Voktar will be grateful for the assistance.
May your blades
be all right, so we need to take care of that, but also a quest from Conqueror Krenna.
What can I do for you?
My enemy's friend.
If there is one thing I cannot get through your head, let it be this. The Alliance will be crushed in the Grizzly Hills. There's far too much lumber, ore, game, and strategic territory for us to give up on any single battlefront here. So far, we've been successful, but there's something that could tip the scales in our enemy's favor. Far to the east of here, at the Forest's Edge Post, local trappers seek to join the Alliance. Slaughter them before they have the chance to do so.
Alright, so we have Silverbrook Hunters and Vladek to take care of. We need to report to Scout Vortok, and then also take care of the little problem that our hide trader has. So, let's see. We just need to find the local blacksmith. Whoever repairs will be able to give us that. Oh, trade goods. That'll actually work.
Greetings, man.
No, it won't.
Strength
okay, so buy some coal, and then talk to the provisioner, who we've talked to before.
Blood and
get, I think it's simple flour, so just get a thing of simple flour. There we go. Hi, trader, we're back. Junik's cover up.
You get the stuff, man.
Yes, I did.
All for the best, man.
Delivery to Krenna.
This is it, man. Let's take these hides to Krenna and see if they pass the test. Let's hope for both our sakes. Krenna doesn't notice anything.
Okay, so basically he's making me take it to Krenna. That's the way it works, people. All right, conquer Krenna.
Do not think for a second that your past accomplishments entitle you to anything, Drakfu. They do not. If you want my respect, you're going to have to earn it. This means following my orders without question and fulfilling them without exceptions.
I have a delivery for you.
Do you have any idea who you're talking to?
Yes.
Just who do you take me for? These hides smell of flour. This is a complete insult to the Horde.
I'm sorry.
May your blade never die.
That spineless troll has failed me for the last time. Anthis, break his legs.
Oh, do we really need to do that?
At once, my lady.
Oh, at once? At once, my lady. Let me take care of it, sister. I can't even tell. Are these men or women? They are men! Okay.
I've never seen you so eager to cause harm to someone else, sister. Such a pleasant development. Very well, go.
Oh, they're Gorgana. Okay. For a second there, I was like, how's that sister? No, don't hurt the guy taker. Let's see, so...
Now don't move if you ever want to walk again. What were you thinking, provoking her like that?
Okay, so that sucked. Krenna's a little bit of a biatch, but that's okay. We will move forward with our other quests, and starting, of course, with Vladek and the Silverbrook Hunters, which technically we could have taken care of with the Grizzlies, but unfortunately Krenna wasn't giving it to us.
That sucks. That's okay, though. You can see the tower off in the distance. There's a bunch of little outposts here and there in Grizzly Hills.
Except this one in particular is special because it's an Alliance outpost and we need to take it out. Oh, look. Look at all the Silverbrook Hunters.
Fist of Fury!
Oh, wait, what? Did they become worgen? Mikhail's Journal. We just barely got a new quest. From what you can gather, this journal was written by the denizens of Silverbrook named Mikhail. It is written in some variant of the common human tongue. Perhaps you should bring this to Conqueror Krenna. Interesting. Okay, so, well, let's go ahead and finish up the quest that we have here. Thankfully, it's not going to take too long. Since I just put a big old dent in it. Boom!
I can't carry any more of them.
And yeah, so, these guys will continue to drop, the Mikhail's journal until you actually start the quest line. So we're not going to worry too much about that. We're almost done. That's how fast this takes, because they're all clumped together so close. Oh, look, and yet another one can become a worgen. I wonder why that is. Well, it's not our duty to think, right? We're just a little grunt in the horde, right? So let's go ahead and go over to Conquest Hold and deliver our findings and see what happens. Black River Logging Camp, and then there is Conquest Hold. Now get used to this architecture because, well, you're probably already used to it by now. Actually, no, you're probably not, because we saw it in the later end of Eastern Kingdoms. This is basically the Garrosh Horde, which is more metal than what I like to call the Thrall Horde, which is wooden. So you just got to get used to the metal structures, because that's going to be a thing from here on. Corona, we have some things for you. Yes. My enemy's friend.
You're back, and you're alive. Now that's a little... Now what's this nonsense about worgen?
Let's see. Ooh, this is an upgrade. So we're gonna take it. Attack on Silverbrook.
A few hours ago, the trappers were nothing but peasants threatening to add their numbers to the alliances. Now they become something else. An uncertainty. I do not like uncertainties. Go to the hills outside their main town in northern Grizzly Hills, Silverbrook, and help my men crush them.
Okay. And then we have Mikhail's journal.
What's that you've got there?
It's a journal.
Ha! Is this some sort of joke? I barely have any use for books I can actually understand.
Gorgona.
This book is written in the pig tongue the humans use. It needs to be burned immediately. Hand it to my sister Gorgona, and do not waste my time.
Okay, so, Gorgona.
You have something to show me?
Yeah, a journal.
Could it be? The man who wrote this journal feared for his daughter's lives, so he sent them away from Silverbrook. We just captured an outcast in the outskirts of town, about the same age as the eldest daughter. Listen, Drakfu, there's more happening here than meets the eye. We can't just burn this diary.
I'm totally listening to you.
Tactical clemency.
Listen, Drakfu, I need you to act with discretion and speed. One of Krenna's top sergeants has captured a trapper outcast outside of Silverbrook. Now, if things turn out the way they usually do, the prisoner is going to be executed before the day is over. We can't let that happen. You see, the prisoner matches the description of Mikhail's older daughter in his diary. If we set her loose and follow her closely, she'll lead us to whoever's controlling the trappers. Take this letter to her. Go
for it. All right. So as you can see, we're moving into Silverbrook before we head over to Camp Onequa. Oh, and we actually do have an additional quest, and this one is just below the flight path. So we have Sergeant Thurkin. Good troll hunting.
Good for nothing, wretches. They could have had it easy. We extended our hand in peace. All they had to do was give us passage through Draktharon, and we'd have let them be. But no, the prideful little ice trolls decided that they wanted it rough. Now they'll be destroyed, and we'll pass through their precious keep to Zuldrak anyway. We contracted a gang to deliver us captured trolls. Talk to Samir if you want in on the action. You can find him to the northwest of here, due south of Zebhelek.
All right. So we've taken care of that. There is also an additional quest in this hut from Windseer Greyhorn. How may I aid you? So, eyes above.
I've been asked to lend my support to our efforts against the Alliance. At the moment, our military forces are about evenly matched, and we're looking for ways to find an edge. The Imperial Eagles that fly over the mountains and trees in this area would make excellent scouts for us. Take this silver feather and use it to bind my sight to that of them. Being able to see our enemy's movements will grant us the strategic advantage we need. You'll find abundant eagles in the mountains to the east.
All right. So we have a bunch of quests to be able to take on, one of which is local. So let's go ahead and take care of this first before we move on to either Trolls or Silverbrook. And all we have to do is take the silver feather and bind some Imperial Eagles to her. So then at that point she can spy on the Alliance. Those Alliance dogs. Where you play mostly Alliance, Drak. I don't know why you do that.
Because we're playing Horde, dammit. And death to the Alliance, I guess. They didn't give me cookies that one day.
Okay, so this is like the first area that we can go into, but this is also really close to Grizzlemaw. And you might notice that, okay, so we're at Vordrasil's Limb. This is actually a big part of the quest line here, so I'm not going to necessarily reveal it yet until we get the quest for it.
Yay! We have bound an Imperial Eagle.
And for some reason, we can't move. There we go. So go ahead and bind another one.
Ah!
Now they will be our loyal spies. And here's our third eagle. On the wings of eagles. So this is going to be the first upload of Monday. Now, for Drak and Shadow subscribers, we're not entirely done because we will have the finale of Donkey Kong Country up around the same time as this comes up. And then also later in the day, you guys will get the next in the Dungeons and Drakfu series, where we start up the first dungeon of the Burning Crusade with Hellfire Rampart. So you guys have plenty to look forward to today and a bunch of other stuff throughout the week that will be mentioned as we go along. Let's see, that's the fifth eagle. Insert Nickelback song here. On the wings of the eagle, blah, 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 blah. Okay, whatever. Where's my last eagle? I really don't want to have to grab ones from the air, because that's going to be frustrating. Because they move pretty fast, and I don't want to have to deal with that crap. We might have to. There's one. Nope, never mind. That ain't gonna work. Here, birdie, birdie, birdie. Here, birdie. I just need a bird. I just need an eagle. Come on. Ooh, okay. Let's go over here and see if maybe we can find some on this limb. On this big tree trunk. Nope. Where be some eagles? Oh, man. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do a quick magic cut while we find our last eagle, and then we'll head back to Conquest Hold. Okay, we are nearing Conquest Hold. I found my last eagle, and I also forgot to put up the achievement so that we can follow the quest in Grizzly Hills. And you can see, compared to Dragon Blight, this is actually significantly shorter, this zone is. So that'll be to our advantage. And I love the achievement for this one, for Grizzle My Shizzle. It's just funny. So let's go ahead and turn in this Eagle quest with Windseer Greyhorn.
Greetings, traveler.
I thank you, Drakfu. Your help is appreciated.
It's haste, so I don't know if I want that. Is it going to offer me more haste or less? Actually, no. The one I have gives me more attack power if I wanted to use it. But I don't need to because I am level 80, and that's how that works. All right, so the next outpost that we're actually going to hit is the troll outpost that they were talking about at Granite Springs. And on the way, we also will be able to take care of... I think Silverbrook is close by. So we'll just make our way up. All you have to do is just go up these hills. And eventually you'll come across a camp of mercenaries. Right here, Granite Springs. Where's our guy? There he is. So, Samir.
You need something?
Here to get in on the bounty action, eh?
Be careful.
Why, yes! Filling the cages. Old Bud seen better days. Ever since our stay in Ghostlands, he's been useless to us. We've had to find ways to make it on our own. And today that means selling trolls to the highest bidder. Fortunately, we've recently found a use for Bud. Something about his condition allows him to mingle with the local trolls. So we taught him a little game that's turned us a tidy profit. See for yourself, talk to Bud, take him southwest to Drakzin Ruins, and use this cage as soon as he tags a troll.
See you later.
So actually, this is a fun little fact. If you did kind of the extended questing, which unfortunately we didn't really have access to because it's since changed, but there used to be a quest line that actually involved this very mercenary band. And in fact, so like MacPherson, Samir, and Bud, you could actually meet in the Ghostlands, and I believe they were part of the Zul'Aman quest line. And in fact, the reason why Bud is kind of messed up is because he messed with some troll voodoo out in the Ghostlands. So that's something to keep in mind. Let's go ahead and do this, because this is fun.
What can I do for you?
So this is Bud. Bud holds very still, pretending not to hear you. Looking closely, you see a bit of drool drip from under his mask. Oh, and he thinks he's a troll, by the way. I should point that out. Come on. Come on, Bud. Time to play with the ice trolls. Now, I need to stay to the ground on this one. Otherwise, I do lose him. And I do get a little pet bar. We don't really care about... we care only about one ability, and that's where he tags an ice troll. So tag the troll, and then we use the cage on it, and we're good. So first of all, we just need to make our way down to the Draxin ruins, which you can actually see off in the distance. Thankfully, the wolves are more interested in hunting venison than they are hunting human, or blood elf in this case. Okay, so here's the Draxin ruins. We're going to try to avoid these ice serpents. And then all you got to do is tag a troll. Oh, and by the way, he's saying, "Nothing says loving like a little tap on the noggin. Hey, man, take this to my troll brothers." Yeah, he thinks he's a troll. I don't think I made that clear, but yes, he thinks he's a troll. There we go. Crap, he didn't tag him. Oh, good. He did tag him. Yay! You will be it now, brother. Okay, so now we've tagged a... No, never mind. He died before I could actually tag him. Crap. Which means I gotta go back and get Bud. Okay, quick Magicka while we get that done. There we go. Okay, so we've got our live ice troll. Now, people might be confused by that. There's actually a troll empire up in Northrend, and they are the Drakari ice trolls. So get used to blue trolls, because we're going to be dealing with a lot of them. And they're called ice trolls, obviously, because they know how to deal with the cold climate. So let's go ahead and turn this in. We now have our live ice troll. And let's turn it in with Samir.
Greetings.
Great work, Monk. Looks like we'll be keeping Bud around a little longer. We'll have your cage picked up right away. Here's your share of the bounty. Oh, and welcome to the camp. Stick around, and I'm sure we'll find a use for you.
Let's see. So we get a sword. Ooh, those are legit upgrades. So I'm going to grab that yoke slasher. And let's see. Which one is it a better upgrade for? This is the fun part when we have upgrades, finally. Oh, where is it in the freaking... Ah! My inventory is so built up. Let's see. There it is. Okay, so Yoke Slasher. It is probably better... I'm going to get rid of the Edge of the Tuskar because I want to be using a legit sword from here on. Let's see. So the next thing we have is Drakuru here actually has a quest for us.
Watch yourself, man.
So the quest is Truce.
Drakuru shrunk more blood elves' heads than I can remember. And even if I could remember... I couldn't count that high. Lucky for you, I'd be stuck in this cage, and I'd be adding one more to the list. Or I'd be adding one more. But things being what they are, maybe we'd be putting our differences aside for a time, eh? Drakuru know things, man. Things that will aid you in your struggle here.
Drakuru cuts the palm of his hand in one of his trusks and extends it through the cage.
So, what'd you say, man? Truce?
So you have to make a blood pact with Drakuru, and the way that you do that is go to the reagents. Oh, never mind. Who has it then? One of these guys has it, I think. Or actually, no. You actually... My bad. I'm thinking of another quest. So you use this dull carving knife, and you use it on yourself to make a blood pact with him. Ah! That hurt! Shake Drakuru's outstretched hand.
Spirits be with you, man.
And there you go. So, truce?
Yeah. Now we be connected by blood, man. A true bond we be having. You listen carefully to Drakuru, blood elf. There be much to do.
Vial of visions.
First things first, man. There be some preparatory work that needs doing. No telling how long they gonna keep me here. you be needing a powerful elixir so we can be keeping in touch. Lucky for you, I know just a thing, and the ingredients are all close by. I need a vial from the pretty little troll over there, some water weed from the lake just north of here, and a few haze leaves found around the camp here. Hurry now, mon, before they be hauling me away.
Now, Drakfu is actually an interesting character that we might have a little bit of a lore gap, and it's just because some of his lore extends into a dungeon. But that's okay. We'll make it work as best as we can. But first of all, let's go ahead and collect all of the ingredients that he needed. So we need some haze leaf, which is all easy to obtain just right here in the camp. And thankfully, that's the third one. Then we go up to the lake here, and we get our waterweed frond, which we need. You can see it right there. And there be river threshers. Oh, jeez, they're dinosaurs! Oh, and we've gone into official troll territory because we have the music. Let's see, and then all we need is a crystal vial, which we can get from a reagents vendor. So, go ahead and grab this. It gives you 20 now, but okay, whatever.
Drakfu!
You got this stuff, man.
Yes, I did!
Drakfu takes the ingredients and deftly combines them in the vial.
This should do it, man. Now it be time to get to work.
Subject to interpretation. A legendary set of artifacts lost for thousands of years were created to make Drakthiron keep impervious.
Most think they be myth, but Drakfu knows better, man. I nearly discovered where one be, but got captured while interpreting hieroglyphs. You gotta summon my soul back there so I can finish reading them. Use my elixir at Abrasia at Draxine Ruins, southeast of here. You'll have to mix in the frozen mojo my brothers be holding. I hate to see my brothers fall, but it be for the greater good.
Stay away from them.
Okay, so we have that, but we also have an additional quest out here from Prigmon. Scourge Kebab!
Ugh. Wrapping up these unfortunate trolls be making my heart ache, but not so much as my back. Help old Brigman out and haul one of these carcasses over to Mac. If we don't burn them, they be walking again in no time.
Stay away from them.
Okay, so all you have to do is... I believe, yeah, you take this mummified corpse, and you fly it over to, because I'm lazy, you fly it over to MacPherson, and he'll burn it.
To you.
What you got there, Blood Elf? I've got your corpse. Oh, my bad. We actually can use it. So, where is it? There we go. And then we just turn this in with Mac. Nothing better than watch them scourge burn. Them scourge burn, eh? He's drunk.
Wrote a little song about it. Want to hear it? Here it goes.
Seared Scourge.
Oh,
my bad. He's gonna sing. Oh no.
Scourge trolls are roasting on an open fire. Bleh. That's it, far as I got. What'd you think?
Hey there.
Alright, Seared Scourge.
Gotta burn these corpses before they start walking around again. Papa always said, only thing worse than having to kill a troll is having to kill a troll twice. Say, speaking of Scourge, we can't get into the troll keep north till we get them trolls thinned out a bit. How about you take some of my grog here and put them bastards out of misery?
See you around.
Alright, so we have now an additional quest to take care of some trolls near Drakthiron Keep, actually. Plenty of stuff to be doing. Oh, and we have another quest here from Prigmon. Let's go ahead and take that.
What you want?
Shimmer caps do.
Say, while you're here, how about you help old Prigmon with a little chore? I got a friend who can make me a mean stew, one like you never tasted before. There be a few ingredients found in these parts that he be needing. They be in the ruins to the southwest and the camp just north of here. What do you say, mon?
So we need to get 5 shimmering snow caps and 5 ice serpent eyes. Spirits okay. So we got lots to take care of. Let's see. Yeah, actually. Let's go ahead and do a quick questing break while we grab all of the ingredients for the Shimmer Caps too. So, questing break, go! Okay, so we have all of the stew ingredients, but also while I was here, I took care of the frozen mojo that we needed to get from the trolls out here. So let's go ahead and use the Drakuru's elixir, and then we will be able to see the image of Drakuru.
What you want?
Ah, yes, you done good, man. I be reading the...
Oh, wait, are we under attack? Yes. Shut up. There we go.
How you do it?
You done good, man. I be reading the wars just fine from here. And at that point, we get a helm. That is actually kind of better. I'll debate that later. Sacrifices must be made. I've got it, man. To the north, one of the ziggurat, on the ziggurat at Zebhalak, be a stone head with ruby eyes. One of them be the eye of the prophets. Bring it to the brazier there and drink my elixir. Again, you be needing some mojo for my elixir to work. This time from the warlord Zimbo. He be hiding in one of the huts in Zebalok. It be a shame to kill Zimbo, man. But he swore the blood oath to defend Drakthoron, and then he done failed. Now at least his mojo be helping us to reclaim Drakthoron.
Stay away from him.
Alright, so we need to grab the Eye of the Prophets, and then also the mojo that we need from Warlord Zimbo. But first, let's head back over to the mercenary camp and get some nice shimmer caps too. We worked our butt off, so we might as well get the reward.
Hello, I'm back, Prigmon. I got your stuff.
Talk to me.
You get those ingredients for old Prigmon Drakfu? Yes, I did.
Oh man, shimmer cap stew. I can almost taste it already.
Say hello to my little friend. Akor is gonna drop a gold brick when he sees these choice ingredients. All that be left is getting them to him. He's camped out on the eastern coast near them haunted ruins, Drakajin, they be called. You'll likely be making it there before I can finish up with these corpses, unless you think you'd rather try your hand at embalming.
Later.
Okay, so this is just gonna be a quest that we can take on way later when we get to the coast of Grizzly Hills. That's gonna be just fine. But with that, we're actually getting to, it's going to be that time. So unfortunately, we're going to go ahead and wrap things up for today. When we get back on Wednesday, we will continue our questing in the Grizzly Hills. We'll see you then.